I have captioned my talk as Reinventing Consumption and Business for Equilibrium. I started learning marketing about 40 years back, still learning. Halfway through, I asked a question. The kind of marketing and management that we are practicing in this country and preaching, is that creating some problems? And what I am sharing with you is, so far, my thinking, churning of that knowledge, as is our culture, with a firm belief. There's nothing like East or West. There's nothing like one is right, other one is wrong. Basic question is, the path that we have chosen, is it the right one for us? And what it does for us in future, what do we learn? My definition of consumption, all of us are consumers, and in this country, if you look at the issues of environment, we had talks about sustainability, we had issues of congestion. I'm focusing on basically three themes. How do we move towards more responsible consumption? Number two, how do we change our business practices, at least introspect? Number three, as a society, as people, how do we not become imitators? How do we move towards a more holistic way of looking at things, which is sustainable, which makes sure that we are also bothered about not just what we are consuming today, but what happens to the future? I'm just raising some questions. 92, a Canadian PM asked a question that if 7 billion population follows what the West consumes, how many Earths do we need? Today, after almost three decades, if we ask a question that if just China and India follow the Western consumption standards, where will we be? So when I heard about the topic equilibrium, what came to mind is first, a seesaw. Seesaw is best when it is in movement. It's not in equilibrium when it's so-called in balance. But equilibrium is about balance. It's about harmony, but harmony in motion. And that gave me this whole focus for today. Anywhere we see around us, the kind of waste, the kind of mental tension that we carry, is it worth having? Garbage, pollution, a cricket match had to be stopped in Delhi, and somebody talked about the kind of air that our children breathe when they develop as adults. What kind of demographic development or demographic dividend this will pay? A few years back, some management expert, a practitioner, talked about new normal is VUCA. I have been a student of poverty. I have been a student of development apart from management. VUCA stands for variability, uncertainty, complexity, ambiguity. I wondered if any one of us who has seen poverty from close eyes, has experienced it, has seen agriculture, has seen the problems of farmers. VUCA is a reality every day in this country. So the question I'm asking is, do we listen to stories coming from only one part of the world? Do we listen to learn only from knowledge which comes from one part of the world? Or we need to look for the best that the both sides have to offer? So talking about responsible consumption, It appears as if somebody is trying to restrain people from consuming, but as a professor, I first like to frame the issue. Typically, we acquire and use things in three major roles. We use it as consumer, we use it as client, and we use it as citizen. And most of our discussions, if you look at, problem happens when we confuse these three roles. So very quickly, I will just look at consumption as consumer. People say consumer is king or queen. At least in my experience of last 40 years in this country, nowhere I have seen consumer being king or queen. But the issue we need to ask very simply is more choice always good? When we are given choice, do we have knowledge to know what is the best thing for us? And lastly, I'm asking a question in our context again. And I will take two examples to support that. Is access more important in our culture, even as consumers, or ownership is more important? We are proud of penetration of mobile phones in this country. Poor also use it. Lots of examples are cited, how some farmer got a better price. In our neighborhood, Bangladesh, somebody created Grameen telephones. Access was provided to rural poor. No ownership was required. The question I'm asking is, looking at e-waste, looking at problems of charging these mobiles, looking at prepaid and postpaid costs, and looking at our average national per capita income. Does ownership-based models, and I have lost count of how many models of mobile phones exist in this country, does that make sense for our kind of market? Or the Bangladesh model of providing access without ownership makes sense? Same may be true for public transport. Same may be true for, if you ask me, health, education, and that's where I go to. As clients, the difference between consumer and client I make is the autonomy of a consumer gets constrained when we become a client. We do not tell a professor what he should teach us. Yes, feedback is taken. We don't tell a doctor what he or she should prescribe. We don't tell a lawyer what he or she should argue. So that's where when we become a client, which happens mostly in utilities, health, education, those kinds of domain. When we create choices, somebody has to ask a question. Discrimination leads to distortion. And currently, even this government is now worrying about that when right to education is enforced, are we making public institutions unviable and we are making private institutions viable? Is the distance between the learners in these two different forms of education increasing? Same questions are being asked with regard to affordable healthcare. I still maintain that our healthcare in this country is not maintained courtesy corporate sector hospitals. Yes, they do perform a role. Equilibrium is provided more by the public health services. Whole lot of untrained, in some cases, quacks. Some cases from whole lot of different backgrounds that people have come in Ayush system. But they are the fellows who are providing the succor where it is required. And the issue that one is basically talking about is promoting anyone at the cost of the other, regulating anyone, leaving the other aside. Does that create disequilibrium, disharmony? And same is true for education. I'm not getting into the kind of having been in the system, having been an insider. Yes, I have issues. But in the context of equilibrium, the question that I am using is, have we lost balance? If education is about liberating minds, is that the kind of education being provided either in the public system or private system? In terms of citizenship, where regulatory and developmental consumption happens, we talk about rights and duties. The issue I am raising is, have rights taken over duties? And little that I know about our history, we did not have concept of rights. We had concept of duties. But in the duty of one, the rights of the other was enshrined. And that's how harmony was achieved. That's how balance was achieved. Somewhere, again, we seem to have lost. Now, if we have to move towards this service provider side, we talked about the demand side from the service provider side. Simple question that I'm asking is, the focus that we have in terms of learning from the wisdom of the West only, getting into the ranking system created by the West, getting into the medical system created by the West, can the wisdom coming from the mature materialistic markets of West provide us solutions for our problems? And again, I repeat, I'm not saying that that knowledge is irrelevant. What I am saying is, we need to examine, we need to question the relevance, we need to question what impact it's likely to have on our system, and that's how we proceed. Just some simple question about the current market practices or business practices I am raising. Focus on market share. It comes from saturated markets where the size of the cake is limited. We are talking about nascent, high potential, aspirational markets of this country. And we need to nurture this, not through blind imitation of the practices coming from there. Market share orientation unnecessarily makes us competition centric. I have been advocating that if we are focused on customers, if we are focused on our society, we have a much greater growth possibility compared to if you are simply focused on competitor. In fact, competitor centrism basically makes us more denominator oriented because we start manufacturing market share. ROCE, if return is difficult to improve, we start reducing the capital employed. This is what I call managing by managing the denominator. Balance requires, equilibrium requires that we manage both the numerator and the denominator. So, what is the solution? My simple prescription is, we need to balance the requirements of Daridra Narayan and Lakshmi Narayan. For English speaking world, this means requirements of poorest of the poor and the rich need to be balanced. We are not doing charity. I am dead against a word called CSR. Corporate social responsibility. It appears as if there is something called irresponsible behavior, and to balance against that, a percentage of atonement. Like many of us, when we commit sins, we visit God once in a while and deposit something, either known or unknown amounts. That's not the thing. If corporates also take the route of citizenship, and I call it citizen corporates, then citizens are basically, the best definition of citizenship that I have is obedience to unenforceable. So whether as individual consumer, client and citizen, or as corporates, if we have obedience to unenforceable, lots of our problems are over. And the model that I propose, and that's a normative approach, let's forget about competition. Can we promote cooperation, but without collusion? Can we coexist without trying to use predatory methods to kill each other? Can we focus on the wellness of the people? Please remember, happiness is momentary. Lots of world is talking about, are we happy? There's a lot of research on happiness. I have interest. We'll not get into that. But simple notion I'm trying to share with you is, till our reference point is outside us, we remain unhappy. That's one of the learning that we get from our own wisdom. But the balance requires that yes, we need to be happy, at the same time, we need to consume. So how do we really balance these two things? The business practice that I'm talking about is, can we look at balancing short-term, medium-term, and long-term? Three roles I propose for anybody working in the corporate sector. That of a gardener, that of a farmer, and that of a forester. Gardeners normally have one season mindset. Farmers, if you're familiar with sugarcane farming, which is quite prevalent in this estate also, a three-year perspective minimum. And people who don't know the proposed policies that look, you announce a particular price for an output and farmer will change his cropping pattern. It doesn't happen. Foresters have 10 years, 15 years, 30 years. A sandalwood tree matures in 35 to 40 years. And you need to have that perspective. So what we do today in terms of business practices, it has a season's impact. Yes, we also get judged on daily basis, weekly basis, quarterly basis. But we need to have trade-off, we need to balance. And that balance is required in terms of these three roles. And lastly, I am concluding by saying, I am no Gandhian, but I have studied Gandhi. I have been associated with certain Gandhian organizations. Mahatma Gandhi talked about, because today when I talk about Gandhi, people will confuse with several other Gandhis. And that's why one has to qualify that there was somebody called Mahatma. And Mahatma talked about balancing need with greed. The earth has enough for everyone's need, but it doesn't have enough for everybody's greed. Can we look at that? He also talked about, let our houses, windows and doors be open for ideas from anywhere, but let us not get swept off our feet. We seem to be getting swept off our feet. In terms of developing knowledge, whether in management or science or anywhere else, my humble submission is, can we look at relevance, insight, and impact? Can we look at our whole system? If you look at the ancient system, it talked about internal validation of an idea. Learning, churning, thinking, and then professing something. I'm not saying external validation is not required. What we need is balancing that external with internal validation, which has been a strength of our system. And lastly, I'm saying equilibrium is not about stagnation or status quo. It's about balance and harmony. Let's develop harmony with nature. Development without destruction should be the motto of consumption as well as business. Thank you.